Spark TV. Metal in action.
So hi everybody out there, you are watching Spark TV Metal in Action. You know, I'm very happy when I'm sitting behind her every time because I feel something special, you know. That's Elisa from Arch Enemy, you know. Nice to see you once again. How are you?
I'm good, how are you?
We have something for fans, of course, they are asking very many times. So at the first point about your vocal range, we can start. When did you find that you can sing so deep?
Right. I don't know. I started singing just like, you know, for fun in high school, doing like plays and theater things like that. Actually, at that point though, I remember really being a different kind of a singer. Like I sang very, like in a very theatrical way, in the sense that I never pushed my chest voice. I switched into falsetto voice very easily, just to get up in the range of a lot of musical theater songs without expressing too much emotion, very, very clearly enunciating every word, because that is the style of musical theater, you know? And so that's how I was doing that. And then when I started being in bands a couple years after that, then I started kind of pushing my chest voice a lot more because I couldn't hear myself because it's so loud in a jam space with a shitty PA that you can't hear your voice. And so I started belting a lot louder because that was the only way I could hear my voice. And in doing that, I developed a pretty strong, like, high chest voice. And then, of course, you know, I developed this technique of growling or whatever you want to call it, and I've just been honing that skill for, you know, over a decade now, or like I think even close to 15 years actually. Oh my god. Yeah. But yeah, so for like about 15 years I've been developing that technique. I don't know what the technique is called. It's just something I do, but yeah, I don't know. So practice, I guess.
How do you practice?
Well, I practice a lot just by being on tour.
Okay.
But if you aren't in the situation where you're touring a lot, obviously like rehearsing with your band is a good way to practice. If I'm not rehearsing with these guys, I still stay active, you know, like I'll do guest appearances with my friends' bands or something like that. Mm-hmm. I also have like a studio set up where I can go and be as loud as I want. Like I have a soundproof booth that I can go in and practice. You know, I'll do scales. It depends on what I feel like working on, you know? So if I just wanna warm up my voice and get ready for a show, then I'll, you know, do a lot of like humming and just vibrational things just to get it ready. But then if I feel like developing a skill, like for example, vocal riffing or vocal runs, which is used more in R&B, not really in metal, but I still like that though, like just because it's fun to do that. So I always practice that too, just because I figure it's a good tool to have. But yeah, so I just have like a variety of different warm-ups that I try to do. Recently I started looking up like on YouTube, you can just search like vocal warm-ups for, you know, like if you feel a certain, you know, sometimes I feel that my voice is tense or that I have cracking when I flip between voices, or, you know, like depending on what my problem might be, I'll just like search that, and then you can find a lot of like vocal teachers on YouTube that are offering advice. Mm-hmm. I've never taken a vocal lesson, so I don't adhere to any particular school when it comes to singing, but I like to learn from as many people as I can, you know. Also, when we go on tour, I always try to learn from every vocalist that I'm on tour with, whether it be, you know, Mille from Creator or Christina from Lacuna Coil or whoever it is. I like to just pick up a little bit of their technique and incorporate it into my own. Or Floor from Nightwish, of course, is a wealth of knowledge when it comes to vocals. So, yeah, I just try to.
So, what is your most deepest tone that you can sing?
I guess I do some of that on Will to Power, actually.
Okay.
Yeah. I like to do that live a lot because it's fun for me, but I know it doesn't always like project super loud because it's just like a quieter growl than my other growl, so I think it's really annoying for my sound guy when I do that. But I definitely hit some low ones on Will to Power, I think. Even on War Eternal, like the song Down to Nothing, there's like a lot of low ones in there.
Can you show it?
Not right now, no.
Okay, and on the other hand, what is your most highest tone?
Yeah, so the high singing, that's kind of funny because, okay, so I did this thing called like Swan Lake a few years ago, which I just basically covered Tchaikovsky's Swan Lake, but completely a cappella. and there's some super, super high notes in there. And it's funny because, like, I think it's Cubase. I don't remember what the program is because it wasn't at my studio, it was at another studio, but I was recording some harmonies that I was doing for Doyle's album, actually. I was doing these, like, ghostly, operatic harmonies. And so, you know, we were listening back to the takes and everything, and we were just trying to, you know, we were trying to find the harmonies. And so we had the keyboard and we were trying to, like, plot out, like, the notes, like, okay, I should sing this line and that line. And then when we did it in the computer, the note that I hit actually, like, went off the register of vocals. So it was like, well, it's a good thing it's in tune, because we wouldn't be able to fix it anyways, because it's off the chart, actually. So whatever that really high note is, that's it. And I mean, it doesn't, it's not like a beautiful note or anything, it's really high, but yeah, I don't know. I at one point I tried to measure my range on a keyboard, and I think it was like almost 4 octaves or something. I don't know if that's good. That's what it was.
So what do you enjoy more? Deep voice or high voice?
I think for live, I prefer the deep voice because it's easier to, like, hear, like, just that frequency. For me, I hear it better, whereas, like, a high voice, maybe that just blends into, like, the guitars and the cymbals, and it's, like, harder to hear it. And of course, like, performing a show live is not really fun when you can't hear what's going on, so I would say probably the deeper voice.
Oh.
Yeah.
Deeper voice, like.
Yeah.
Is it hard to learn it?
Well, I kind of just, because I'm self-taught, I kind of just...
Or can I learn it?
I don't know. I mean, I have no idea. I'm, like, not a good... I don't know if I'm a good teacher or not. I don't know, like... Like, because I'm self-taught, I just try to... Like, if I think of an idea and I'm like, oh, I think that would sound good, I just try to do it. And then if it sounds good, then I continue to develop that. And if it sounds bad, then I just, like, don't do it anymore, you know?
Okay, yeah.
But I think that, I mean, I guess anybody, I don't know, I have no idea. I don't know if this is, like, special or not. I just do it.
Because I think it's much more easier to learn to sing, like, normal, like, no.
Like,
it's more melodic. I think it's much more, but to deep voice, like, no. This end.
Well, because that's, I mean, because your vocal cords, right, like, when you're going lower, they're looser, right?
Yeah.
And then when you're going higher, they're tightening up, and so it makes the vibrations faster. But, and you can always tighten a little bit more, but once it's loose, you can't really, like, loosen it anymore, you know? It only goes as loose as it goes. So, so of course, you know, my low range is limited. I don't think my low range is that good. My high range is something I've been developing because, like I said, it was the only thing I could fucking hear in the jam space, so that one I've developed a little bit more, but my low range is something I actually try to work on still.
Stay tuned, more coming soon.
And it was something that I had drawn a long time ago and I knew I wanted to get. I also have a tattoo that goes, like, all the way from up here all the way to down there. This is actually taken from the Arch Enemy logo, the pentagram of the Arch Enemy logo, but of course it's a pentagram, but then...
Nové album Arch Enemy Will to Power si můžeš už teď předobjednat na Sparker.cz. Spark TV. Metal in action.